Hello friends, welcome to my channel Civil Structures. Today we will design two-way slab. Let's see an example. Design a reinforced concrete slab for a room of clear dimension 4 meter by 5 meter. The slab is supported on walls of width 230 mm. The slab is carrying a live load of 4 kN per meter square. Use M25 and Fe415. The corners of the slabs are held down. Now what is the meaning of the corners are held down and not held down? You can search my previous video. I will give I button here. Here the given data is longer dimension of the slab is 5 meter. The shorter dimension is 4 meter. Live load is 4 kN per meter square. We have to use here M25 and Fe415. And the corners of the slabs are held down. Then the calculation steps. First is the depth calculation, effective span calculation, then bending moment calculation. Then we have to calculate the main reinforcement, which is for the middle strip reinforcement along the both direction. Then edge strip reinforcement, torsional reinforcement. And the lastly, we have to check for shear and the deflection check. And finally, we have to draw the detailing drawing.
Step 1 is determine the depth of slab. Okay, as we have our given data that the longer span is 5 meter and the shorter span is 4 meter. Also, we have the value of live load and that is 4 kN per meter square. As per clause number 24.1 on page number 39, if my shorter span is less than equal to 3.5 meter and if I have live load less than equal to 3 kN per meter square, then my span by depth ratio, it is L by D, it should be 35 multiplied by modification factor if I am using Fe250, and my span by depth ratio, it should be 35 multiplied by modification factor multiplied by 0.8 if I am using Fe415. Fe250 is nothing but mild steel and Fe415 is HOSD steel bars. But you can see here my shorter span is more than 3.5 meter and my live load, which is 4 kN per meter square, which is more than 3 kN per meter square. So my L by D ratio, as in span by depth ratio, is nothing but 20 multiplied by modification factor. As per clause number 23.2.1, we have to take here L by D ratio is equal to 20 multiplied by modification factor. Why? Because I'm taking here my two-way slab is simply supported. Okay, now to determine the span by depth ratio, we have to determine the modification factor. How we can determine our modification factor? From figure 4, we have to check the graph for the modification factor with respect to the percentage of reinforcement, where my FS value is 0.58 FY AST required upon AST provided. As if we are not providing here AST required and AST provided, so we can take AST required and AST provided ratio is 1 and my FS value is 0.58 FY. Okay, and it will be 240 Newton per mm square. Now to determine modification factor, we require the value of percentage of reinforcement along with FS value. Here we have to assume our PT value. We can assume between 0.3 to 0.6 percentage for the slabs. Let me assume here 0.4 percentage. So if I have value PT is 0.4 percentage and the value of FS to 40 Newton per mm square, I can determine my modification factor 1.3 and my span by depth ratio 20 multiplied by modification factor. Here I have to take my clear span, which is the shorter span. I'm taking 4000 mm and I can determine my depth D 153.84 mm. With taking round off value, I'm taking 160 mm effective depth D. So my capital depth D, as in total depth, is effective depth plus clear cover plus bar diameter divided by. So the total depth is, effective depth is 160. I'm taking clear cover 20 mm plus, I'm assuming 10 mm bar diameter divided by 2. And my capital D is 185 mm. Okay. So we provide capital D 185 mm. And the effective depth 160 mm. Step number 2 is to determine the effective span for both directions, for longer span also and for shorter span also. Rules for the effective span you can check in my previous video. I'm giving you I button here. So determine the effective span. My first parameter is clear span plus effective depth. So here my clear span for the shorter direction is 4000 mm. Plus effective depth is 160 mm. Second parameter is clear span plus support by 2 plus support by 2 center to center distance. So here my clear span is 4000, support width we are having 230 mm plus 230 mm divided by 2. Okay, and here it is 4230 mm. We have to take the lesser value from both. Here my effective span in shorter direction, I'm giving LX notation. The value is 4160 mm. Okay, now similarly for the longer span LY, if I'm doing the same procedure, okay, and the value will be 5160 mm, and this is for longer span. Our next step is to determine the loads on the particular slab. For that we have to determine first the self weight of the slab. Self weight we can determine with the thickness of slab multiplied by the density of concrete, and as if we are taking per meter width of the self weight of the slab. Okay, so my thickness of the slab, here is my capital D is 185 mm. So my thickness will be 0.185 meter. Okay, my density of the concrete will be 25 kilonewton per meter cube multiplied by 1. Okay, so my self weight will be 4.625 kilonewton per meter. We are calculating the self weight of the slab with per meter width. Okay, we have to assume the flow finish load. Let me take 0.8 kilonewton per meter square. Here also I'm taking per meter width. Okay, so it is 0.8 kilonewton per meter. Given live load is 4 kilonewton per meter square. This value also I'm taking per meter width. It is 4 kilonewton per meter. So the total is 9.425 kilonewton per meter. We have to take factor load. Okay, so we have to multiply with 1.5. What is 1.5 here? It is a multiplication factor for the RCC elements. It is 14.13 kilonewton per meter. So I'm taking WU as in notation, as in UDL, 14.13 kilonewton per meter. Next step is the calculation of bending moment. As we know, we are taking here simply supported slab. So as per IS 456, table number 26, we have to decide our type of panel. Okay, as it is a simply supported slab, so I'm taking here case number 9, 4H discontinuous. So we fixed our type of panel. With the help of that, we can determine our bending moment coefficients. Okay, so we have to determine short span coefficient, which is alpha x and alpha y is long span coefficients. Ly by Lx ratio, as in ratio longer span to the shorter span. Okay, and that is 5 by 4 is equal to 1.25. okay, so we have to take here interpolation to determine the value of alpha x. So how we determine our interpolation? For Ly by Lx 1.2, I have value 0.072, and for 1.3, 0.079. We have determined 4ly by lx 1.25. After interpolation, we can determine the value of alpha x is 0.075. And for alpha y, value is directly given for case number 9. It is 0.056. Okay. Now with the help of this coefficients, we can determine the moments about x. The formula is alpha x wu lx square, and for moment about y, alpha y wu lx square. This formula is given IS 456-2000, page number 90. Here the value of lx, we have to take the effective span. So moment about x will be 18.33. Moment about x will be 18.33 kilonewton into meter. Similarly, for moment about y, it is 13.69 kilonewton into. Now let's check the depth. Formula for mu limit is 0.138 fck bd square as per IS 456. We have to take here maximum moment 18.33 into 10 raised to 6 newton into mm. 0.138 is a coefficient for fck 25, fe 415, b as in permittive width, and d effective depth we have to determine here. Okay, so here my value of d I can determine is 72.89 mm, which is required, and I have provided here 160 mm, which is more than d required. So here my depth check is okay. Next step is to determine the reinforcement along both direction, as it is two-way slab. Here our main reinforcement will be along both direction. So let's first determine along the shortest span. Now as per IS 456, we have to determine our main reinforcement in the middle strip only. The middle strip for the shortest span. So let me draw a diagram. Let's say if this is my two-way slab, this is my Ly as in longest span and Lx as in shortest span. Now our first step is to determine the reinforcement along shortest span. So we have to determine our reinforcement along shortest span. So for that, we have to take this particular width, and this will be my edge strips. This particular middle distance is considered as the middle strip. The dimension for middle strip will be 3/4 Ly. So let's determine first the width of middle strip, 3/4 Ly. What is Ly? Effective length in longer direction is 5.16. The value is 3.87 meter. So whatever reinforcement we provided along the shortest span, that will be in particular width middle strip 3.87 meter. We have maximum value of bending moment. With the help of formula of PT, we can determine the value of percentage of reinforcement is 0.2%. B as in 1000 mm, as we have to provide as per the per meter width. The depth D is effective depth we are taking here, 160 mm. With the help of PT, I'm calculating AST. Okay, so value of AST is 320 mm square. Okay, now we have to assume a diameter of bar. Let me take it 8 mm bar diameter. The area of reinforcement for particular bar, as in for 8 mm, is 50.26 mm square. Now we have to determine the spacing. So my spacing calculation, I can determine here 157.1 mm. So let me provide 150 mm center to center. As I usually say in my all videos, that whatever spacing value you have determined, you have to provide the lesser value for the spacing, and where my provided AST will be. Now let's check with the minimum AST requirement. As per clause number 26.5.2.1, we have our minimum AST requirement. You should provide this 0.12% of PT if you are using HYSD bars, 0.12% of cross section of particular section. So if I'm taking cross section of a member, we have to take our capital D here. Okay, so my value of AST minimum should be 216 mm square. Here we have provided 335.33 mm square, so we are okay with our AST provision. So let me just write, provide 8 mm bar diameter at 150 mm center to center in the middle strip of the two-way slab along shorter span. Next step is to determine the reinforcement along longer span. Now let's draw the diagram. I'm providing my reinforcement along longer span. So this will be my 8 strips and this will be my middle strip. The width of my middle strip will be 3 by 4 length of x. So let's determine the width of middle strip. Effective length in x direction is 4160 and my width will be 3.12 meter. This dimension in mm and I'm taking this in meter. Now let's calculate the reinforcement with the help of bending moment value. The bending moment about y is 13.69 kilonewton into meter. With the help of bending moment value, we can determine the percentage of reinforcement we provided. Okay, where we put the, with the help of value of PT, I'm taking AST, B as in 1000 and effective depth is in 160 mm, 243.23 mm square. Okay, now let's determine the spacing. For that we have to take spacing value 206.71 mm. Let me provide 200 mm center to center spacing and my provided AST will be 251.13 mm square. Calculate AST minimum 16 mm square and we provided here AST provided is more than AST minimum, so it is okay. Next step is to determine the reinforcement in 8 strip. As per the annex D in IS 456, we have to provided at least minimum reinforcement. We have already calculated our AST minimum 216 mm square and if we are taking 8 mm of bar diameter, then how many number of bars we have to provide in each 8 strip? So we have to provide 5 number of bars in each 8 strip along x direction and along y direction. Okay, our next step is to determine the torsion reinforcement. As per IS 456 annexure D, we have to provide the steel, the torsion reinforcement at each corner of the slab. Okay, for top reinforcement also and for the bottom reinforcement also. So we have to provide the steel in each layer should be 75% of the maximum AST of the mid span. Okay, so our maximum AST of mid span is as per along x direction, it is 335.3 mm square. So my AST for the torsion reinforcement for the each layer is 251.49 mm square per meter width. Okay, and we have to determine the length of each strip, LX upon 5, 4160 upon 5 and LY upon 5, 1032 mm. So here is a length for the torsion bars along x direction and along y direction. Now if I am taking 8 mm bar diameter for the torsion reinforcement and the spacing should be 199.8 mm and I am providing 190 mm center to center of 8 mm bar diameter for the torsion reinforcement. It is like a mesh we provide. Okay, now let's see the cross section detailing drawing. There is a two-way slab. It is a shorter direction. I am showing the cross section along shorter direction. Okay, the center to center distance between the support is 4.3 meter. Okay, the capital depth is 180 mm. Okay, the effective depth I am showing here is 160 mm. Okay, now you can see this pink line is the reinforcement along x direction. The value is, and we have provided here 8 mm bar diameter at 150 mm. center to center. Okay, now half of the reinforcement should be bent up at the upper portion near the support. Okay, now how much the distance will be? As per an extra D from IS 456, we have to extend the, we have to bent up 50% of the AST into the support and the distance of the bent up bars is 0.15L from the center of the support. If I'm take out, if I calculate 0.15L, is here 624 mm. Now here we have to show the reinforcement along y direction. Okay, so here is the reinforcement along y direction this circular bars, 8 mm bars, 200 mm center to center. Okay, so here is a cross section along y direction, or we can say along the longest span, center to center distance. Okay, you can see here the red line is in reinforcement along y direction, that is 8 mm at 200 mm center to center, and whatever circular bars you can see here, it is the reinforcement along x direction. It is 8 mm at 150 mm center to center. For the required checks, we have to check for shear, and for the deflection check, you can see the previous videos. It is similar as designed for one-way slab.
Okay, now let's see here the plan diagram for the top reinforcement and bottom reinforcement for the two-way slab. Okay, you can see I'm showing here is a bottom reinforcement diagram, and here is a top reinforcement diagram. Okay, so here is a longitudinal direction, and it carries your longest span, and this carries your shortest span. Okay, this blue mesh you can see, okay, blue color linings, which shows the torsional reinforcement, and we have to provide the torsional reinforcement at four corners for the top and bottom both reinforcement. Okay, now the green reinforcement you can see, it is the main reinforcement, which is for the middle reinforcement along the longest span, and the red lines you can see here, here is a middle reinforcement, or we can say the middle strip reinforcement, which is the main reinforcement along shortest span. Okay, and this black reinforcement lines you can see, it is a reinforcement for the edge strips. Okay, and the dimensions of the edge strips and the middle strips we already discussed in the video. Okay, and here the top reinforcement plan. Okay, at four corners we have provided torsional reinforcement, and this middle edge strip reinforcement you can see, which is nothing but the 50% bent up bars we take from the bottom reinforcement. Okay, and the distance for this bent up reinforcement we also discussed in our video.